Live from the Sands Convention Center, Las Vegas, Nevada, extracting the signal from the noise. It's theCUBE, covering HP Discover 2015. Brought to you by HP. And now your hosts, John Furrier and Dave Vellante.
Welcome back, everyone. Live in Las Vegas is HP Discover 2015. SiliconANGLE Media's flagship program, theCUBE, where we go out to the events and extract the signals from noise. I'm John Furrier. My co-host, Dave Vellante, with both co-CEOs of SiliconANGLE Media here, wrapping up HP Discover, so our closing segment of day one. Dave, this is where we break it down and kind of go through everything and kind of put the filter on it. We talked to a lot of folks, a lot of changes at HP. Obviously, the highlights, the Meg Whitman keynote, the new messaging. The Aruba Networks interview is going to come online, but we sat down with Dominic Orr, Dom Orr, earlier and had a great chat. Antonio Neri was just on theCUBE. A lot of great stuff. Quick highlights. Four key pillars of messaging. Hybrid cloud, software-defined infrastructure, protection of the digital assets of the digital-enabled enterprise, data-driven enterprise, workplace productivity, really all about cloud, big data, security, storage, servers. HP's messaging is pretty tight. No product messaging at the high level, it's all solutions. Overall, I'm very impressed with the messaging. The integration of not being, this is my speeds and feeds, my product, is actually pretty compelling. Well, it's a great signal in my opinion.
I said I was looking for, I expected three things, I think we got the three things. One was Meg talking about the split, HP Inc. and Hewlett Packard Enterprise. I thought she did a good job with it. She kept it short and sweet and moved on, right? Because customers, you know, they don't want to get into the inside plumbing. They want to know that you got it covered and they want to know the focus and the reason behind it, they got that. The second thing was those four pillars, that messaging, that's that business outcomes, solutions, that's what customers want to buy. I want to come back and talk to you about that. And the third was products. I liked how Meg and Antonio kicked it back to the floor. We had Manish Goel, for example, talking about HP All Flash and other folks on the floor talking about some of the products. So I thought that was good too. Because at the end of the day, HP's a product company. In terms of the messaging, I liked the idea economy. I mean, I love digital economy, you know that, John. And I think I prefer digital economy, but it's not new. So HP has to lead, it doesn't want to follow. So it comes up with this notion of idea economy. I want to get your thoughts on it.
I kind of disagree with you.
I want to get your thoughts on it. But so let me just tell you what I think at first. So I tweeted out, I said, okay, but it's really the digital economy, but ideas are the mainspring of the digital economy. I don't consume those ideas. Those ideas create services and products that I can then consume. So it's really not an economic dynamic. But what I liked about it was it's different. It's not just me too. And what do you think?
I disagree, I don't like it.
Okay, why not?
I think it's kind of gimmicky. I mean, I like the idea in economy. It just seemed like, it seemed like some glammed up part of it to make the customers, that's your ideas. Now, I don't, you know, it's Kool-Aid injection. Let's just kind of understand what it is. The idea economy is relevant. I like the digital economy. It is about the idea economy, but that's the way life has always been.
Entrepreneurs, I think it vectors in, don't you, to
no,
the digital
no, no,
economy?
No, hold on, let me just say how I feel first. I don't like the idea economy leading as it's a substantive messaging for the company. Of course it's an idea economy. So,
what do you mean of course it's an idea? Nobody's talking about an idea economy. HP's the first talking about that idea economy.
Yeah, but
you hear the API economy,
it's called
the
business.
Digital economy.
It's called business and innovation. It's called entrepreneurship, intrapreneurship. So it depends how you slice it. The meat on the bone is...
That's because you're from Silicon Valley and it's all about ideas.
No, I love the Moneyball story. I thought that was the first trend when you start to see the big data guys use Moneyballs and saying, you could be the next Moneyball. It's a little bit intoxicating. The customers are probably sitting in there going, wow, I love this messaging. I just didn't like it, my personal opinion. I think the messaging around hybrid cloud protection of digital assets were relevant and meaty and substantive. I thought you can point to and saying hybrid cloud software-defined infrastructure, I can get behind that and say, I know what it is. So protection of digital assets, I know what that is, that's security. Data-driven enterprise, that's big data among other things. Workplace productivity, users, I can get behind that messaging. The idea economy is, yeah, it's kind
of. So you don't think it has legs?
No, I don't. I think it, to say Uber's the idea economy, yeah, I mean, Airbnb, it's just a new way to do business, right? A new style of business, I get that. It ties good. Again, I think it's just a kind of, it felt gimmicky to me, that's all I'm saying.
Here's why I liked it. Here's why I liked it. Let me try to take another run at it. So, the notion that you're building on top of what we like to talk about, this digital matrix, this digital fabric, where you've got cloud, you've got security, you've got social media, you've got a data layer, and you're taking an idea and you're combining, like Uber, mobile, global positioning, software, crowdsourcing, social media. That to me is an idea put into action. Now, from an economic standpoint, I'm not buying the idea. The idea creates something. I used the analogy on Twitter today about a piece of fruit. If I eat a piece of fruit, it's gone. You can't eat it. But a digital asset, I can consume it, you can consume it, Leonard can consume it, everybody can consume it. And the marginal economics of that digital economy are very powerful. And I think that's what we're seeing. So I think from an economic standpoint, it's better. But the idea is that scarce resource, as actually Jason said, it's not scarce. It's tons of ideas. It's just people can't implement them because it's too complicated to implement them. But to me, that's where education should be focused. That's where, if I'm not doing storage management, I can free up people to have more ideas that can power the digital economy. So to me, the idea economy, the ideas are the mainspring of the digital economy. And that resonated with me.
Well, of course it does, because it's a great hope. You could be the guy. First of all, everyone's got ideas. And this what separates success from failure is people who actually act on the ideas and execute.
Mark Andreessen.
Act, and execute. So this idea economy, a little bit Pollyanna for me. I didn't like it. It felt gimmicky. That's what I'm just saying. What she really was saying in her keynote, when you actually unpack the subtext, was in order to execute on that idea, which is what matters, HP is going to enable you. So there's an undercurrent of enablement vibe. That really is innovation, right? That's the customer, you know, saying, hey, HP, you're enabling me to be successful. So all of my ideas and pressure that I have to do to execute, you're a partner. And it's also the channel partner. So to me, I think that's key.
And that's what cloud is all about, too, right?
You could call it innovation economy. It's idea economy, innovation, it's entrepreneurship.
But people have used that
It's
before,
agile.
Right?
I know. I'm just saying, it felt gimmicky. However, I like the messaging of speed and that you could be disrupted. If you could be the taxi industry, or you could be Uber. That resonates, because I think as a metaphor, customers can put their arms around that and going, hey, Airbnb was a crazy idea at first, but it was really the model, not so much selling air mattresses out of a bedroom with cereal. It was the notion that a sharing economy is a new construct to do business, and that people will rent their homes out, and the hotel industry is sitting there fat and happy and can be disrupted. So it's hotels for Airbnb and taxis for that. So I get that. What I really was impressed about is HP saying, look, we're about execution. The other thing that I was impressed with HP, Dave, today is that you're starting to see, okay, this is where you can start to see the signaling of HP. They're kind of actually admitting, like, look it, screw all you naysayers out there, we're just going to be HP. And you're starting to see them go back to their roots. I heard the word proprietary once, but they're saying, hey, we're going to just bring legacy back in and then bring the open standards in. So they're kind of saying, Dave, look it, we can be who we are and not worry about all the people throwing the cheap shots from the cheap seats. Stay on the mission under Meg's leadership, and let's bring back the roots. And Antonio said it, apps and data. So embrace the strengths of HP, the legacy business, and bring that in as an asset versus trying to head fake the market and trying to be Amazon, which you can on the cloud side.
Well,
and, you know, obviously you're a box player and you gotta be a solutions player.
Well, I've always said, you know, people always say, well, how do we get the new customers, You're always gonna do more business, especially a company the size of HP, you're going to do more business with your existing company customers than you are your new customers. So that's what the hybrid infrastructure was all about. What we heard from HP today is, we're not forcing people to the public cloud. We're not forcing people to, they sort of kind of took some pot shots at IBM today, I thought, which was sort of interesting.
Yeah.
Saying, hey, we're not forcing people to go into, you know, a PaaS layer and then go into the public cloud. Now, flip side of that is, you know, it's nice to have a robust PaaS layer. Now, of course, Cloud Foundry
What do you think about the strengths? So, converged systems, good, really good. Storage?
Converged systems is behind, in my opinion. Yeah, I mean, HP's got a $300 million converged systems business. VCE's got they're tracking to $3 billion. We're talking about an order of magnitude bigger. HP coined the term, let's give them that, but they have not executed the way they could have, but now they're in a position to. And I think that's been focused.
See their troops lining up to execute?
Yes, finally. It's taken too long, but yes.
Composable applications?
Oh, they're going to kill it in converged infrastructure. I have no doubt about that.
You making that prediction?
Yeah, so they're going to kill it in converged infrastructure because they've got such a loyal customer base. They've finally got their organization together. They're focused on the R&D around composable infrastructure. They're doing all the things that they should have been doing, frankly, 5 years ago.
Were you shocked to hear that HP's number one in public security? 100 billion correlated security events per month.
I wasn't shocked. I mean, I've always liked HP's security story. I was surprised to hear they were number one.
They can slice the market. You can be number one on anything, as Warren Buffett would say. But I mean,
I think they're a leader. I've always liked HP's security story. I think it's a strong story. The rest of the software business, Vertica, I love. Haven's okay.
Colin Mahoney.
Colin Mahoney, rock star, superstar. Vertica, awesome. I love Robert Youngjohn's. Not enough growth in software. HP has to get the software growth engine going, right? And Vertica is the shiny new tool. No talk last conference call about Vertica. We heard a little bit today about Haven. Vertica really is a shining star.
What could they be doing differently? Where's the developer conference, Dave? I want to see a developer conference. What I'm getting out of this show is HP's now poised to win in multiple theaters, but they got to execute their own.
John, they have to connect the dots. You look at what Maritz is doing with Pivotal. They have to connect the dots between cloud and data, and that connection is the PaaS layer.
I think it's the execution economy, Dave. Okay, that might not play well in foreign countries. No, but seriously, execution is the key to success, and HP's got to execute.
Well, but again, like you said to Jason Newton, HP's goal is to enable the execution of those ideas. That was my takeaway.
Well, the social economies here, obviously we're doing our part with theCUBE. I'm very impressed with HP's team embracing the crowd chats. They're really driving that Ferrari really well. HP Discover.social site's going great. The HP social media team is really bulking up and really has a great vision. I think I'm impressed by seeing some early signals there, Dave. So again, we're doing our part, opening it up. We'll be here 3 days coverage. This is day one. This is wrapping up of day one. We'll be back all day tomorrow, all day Thursday. Wall-to-wall coverage. Go to hpdiscover.social for all the keynotes, all the videos, all the assets. That's where the crowd is. It's an organic site. Got all the content there. It's free. Go to crowdchat.net and obviously go to hp.com for their content and join the conversation. I'm Gianfranco De Vellante. We're wrapping up here. We'll see you tomorrow and enjoy the replays. I'm Gianfranco De Vellante. Good night.